This week on The Wire, housing triumphs over COVID-19, listing and confidence rise, and additional payments to mortgages increase. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, housing triumphs over COVID-19. So home lending rose 12.6% in August, the highest monthly figure since January 2018. The latest data from the ABS shows that annual growth in home loans was almost 20%, confirming that the housing market has held up strongly against the pandemic impacts. The largest increases in new mortgage commitments for owner-occupiers were in Victoria, Queensland and New South Wales. The latest CBA economics report says the evidence continues to mount that Australia's housing market is going to come through the COVID-19 pandemic largely unscathed. RateCity.com.au research director Sally Tindall says the value of new loans, were actually higher in August than it was in March. Owner-occupiers led the way with the value of new loans increasing 13.6% from the previous month and 29.2% year-on-year, she says. First homebuyers were at their highest level in over a decade as well, with over 12,000 first homebuyers settling loans in August, the biggest monthly number since October 2009. And now, guys, for our next stories, listings and confidence rise. So new home listings rose in the September period, heralding an increase in property market confidence as the spring selling season gets underway. Listings of homes for sale rose across the country with the exception of Melbourne. Now, Sydney's stock on market rose 1.8% compared to August, and Perth recorded a 0.9% increase, and that's from data coming from SQM Research. Nationally, the number of properties that had been on the market long-term, i.e. from 90 to 180 days, fell 8.6%, indicating increased sales activity. SQM Managing Director Louis Christopher says, "When we see an increase in new stock and a decline in old stock, that normally spells increases in activity in the market. Old stock getting absorbed and new vendors are coming to market." Christopher says the residential market is an increasingly attractive investment. When we consider rental yields, the truth is most cities are offering a cash flow positive properties compared with where lending rates are, he says. I've never seen that before. It's coming from Louis Christopher. And now for our final story of the week, additional payments to mortgages increase. So voluntary payments in a mortgage doubled in July, August and September from the previous 12 months as home loan borrowers paid extra to build a buffer. Data from non-bank lender First Mac shows the level of additional payments made by borrowers rose to an average of 10% of the portfolio in the past 3 months, and that's compared with the monthly average payment of 5% last year. First Mac Chief Financial Officer James Austin says there's obviously a lot of money flowing through the economy and people are choosing to save that money. Remember, paying down the mortgage is another form of saving. In the June quarter, the nation's household savings ratio jumped 20%, the highest level since 1974. The figures indicate a relatively low level of arrear amongst mortgage holders seeking payment relief, which is consistent with data from the Commonwealth Bank. According to the CommBank, over half of the 40,000 customers who deferred their home loan repayments are now ready to start making them again. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to comment, like, and share this video, and don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, guys, and remember, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot, and bye for now.